Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Nikhita.
And I'm Samriddhi. Today, we are here to
explain things as they are. Now, we want you to try to imagine a color that doesn't exist. I know, that sounds insane, but humor us. So this means that the color can't be from the rainbow or between black and white.
Basically, none of the colors on the screen right now.
Safe to say that it seems quite impossible, but it's actually not, because a lot of very young kids can do this quite easily. This is attributed to the fact that they don't have any preconceived ideas or notions about what is possible and what isn't. You've probably done it when you were a little kid as well.
Now, try to imagine creating a language that can be used to communicate effectively. This language has to be completely new and cannot be a derivative of any other. Seems difficult, to say the least, but again, it's been done. One of the more prominent examples being this guy, J.R.R. Tolkien, who created a language Sindarin for his book series, The Lord of the Rings. Now, why is this so hard for some of us? I mean, what did Tolkien have that we don't, apart from his literary genius, of course? What about the little kids then? Turns out, it's all just a difference in perception.
Now, this brings us to the question of what is perception? The Oxford Dictionary, which we refer to because Oxford, defines it as the ability to perceive, which isn't helpful to us at all. So we looked up what to perceive meant, which is to understand or interpret in a certain way. And unsurprisingly, most people don't know the dictionary definitions of words like perception. So we took a few more commonly known meanings and had a little survey, mostly because I wanted a graph in our presentation.
But let's ignore that.
As you can see, most people define perception as how we see. And while none of those meanings are wrong, they're not the exact definitions. They're just how we perceive perception.
Now, how do we perceive? How we perceive shapes what we see. Kind of a weird concept, we know, but bear with us. Now, how many of you are afraid of the dark? Yeah, most of us aren't afraid of the dark itself, which is just an absence or lack of light. But rather, we're afraid of seeing something in the dark.
We are not born with this fear. There could be a million reasons for your aversion to the dark. Maybe you saw something in the corner of your room when you were 11 and you've been paranoid ever since. Or maybe you woke up in the middle of the night and you were 100% sure you saw something outside your window. It could even be something as silly as a horror movie. Now, I'm not gonna lie. The first time I watched A Nightmare on Elm Street, I couldn't sleep for a week without the light on. Regardless, we're all afraid of something we perceive to be in the dark. Our perceptions are created by our minds, as we know, and we only feel fear when we put a face to it, whether it's the little girl from The Ring or Freddy Krueger.
But there could be something beautiful hiding in the dark, and we would never really know because of our fear or perception of the dark.
Our environment, the things around us, also plays a substantial role in shaping our perception. And this is quite contradictory because we just define perception as how we see. It's how I see, so why does the way my parents raised me or the way my teachers taught me have anything to do with it?
Now, this has a lot more to do with sight and neural functions. So to avoid confusing my friend here, and all of you, of course, let me give you an example. Now, that is an apple. What color is the apple?
Red,
exactly. Now, the only reason we know that it's red is because that's been taught to us. Our teachers probably just pointed at that apple or that square and said, red. But how do I know that you aren't seeing this? My red might not be yours. We could each be seeing the world completely different, and we would never really know.
Now, this also begs the question of why this happens. So we have a little activity for you. Now, before we started, we passed out a few sheets of papers. They're on your tables. On the papers are the names of a color. Don't show it to anyone. We want you to try to describe that color without using any examples or using the name of the color itself. So if your color is red, you can't say the color of an apple. And describe it as if you were describing it to someone who was blind. So if your color was blue, you would write that it is cold or wet. You have 1 minute. And time's up. Now, we want you to fold the paper like so and exchange it with someone sitting next to you and see if you can guess what their color was. Okay, I think it's safe to assume that most of you found it a little difficult. This is because our language or our vernacular isn't enough to explain something as versatile and as unique as color. This phenomenon is known as the explanatory gap.
Now, the explanatory gap is quite literally a gap in our abilities to explain. It is our inability to explain qualia as we feel it to others. Yes, I said qualia, and no, we did not make up that word.
We promise.
There have been many different definitions of qualia over time, the simplest being the what it is like character of having mental states. The way it feels to have mental states such as pain, seeing red, smelling a rose, etc. We know, still confusing. Qualia is basically what we feel. It is our unique experiences of feeling pain, of seeing the color red or smelling a rose. Now, back to the explanatory gap. Now let's say I'm trying to explain how a stream sounds to a person who is deaf. I could define the meaning of a stream. I could go into a physics of a stream.
Though we're not completely sure how that would help.
I could tell them what it sounds like to me. I could tell them what notes it forms on the major and minor scales.
This person would have every piece of information pertaining to a stream, but they still wouldn't hear it the same way I do. They could be hearing something completely different in their heads, and I would never know because of the explanatory gap, because our language, as we said before, isn't enough to explain something like it.
But what if we could actually communicate effectively enough to be able to explain our qualia to others and have them experience the same thing?
What if our language evolved enough to be able to help a blind person see the color pink or help a deaf person hear a stream?
We might even be able to see colors that don't exist. Think of all the things we could create if we could just compare our qualia, our perceptions, and completely change them to suit our unique imaginations.
We might see something beautiful in the dark after all. Thank you.